हेलो एंड नमस्ते टू ऑल ऑफ यू. दिस इज जेविन शालू सिंह फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजियोथेरेपी एंड डायग्नोसिस फ्रॉम ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी. सो फॉर टुडेज टॉपिक आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग विद यू अबाउट सर्फेस टेंशन. सो यू वुड हैव ऑफन हर्ड दिस वर्ड. नाउ लेट्स सी वॉट बेसिकली सर्फेस टेंशन इज. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द डेफिनेशन ऑफ सर्फेस टेंशन, it is the phenomena that occurs when the surface of a liquid is in contact with another phase. So it can be liquid as well. So if liquids, they tend to acquire least surface tension or surface area as possible. So the surface of the liquid behaves like an elastic sheet, and surface tension is the tension of surface film of a liquid caused by attraction of the particles in the surface layer by the bulk of liquids, which tend to minimize surface area. Now, the surface tension, it not only depends upon the forces of attraction between the particles within the given liquid, but it also on the forces of attraction of solids, liquids, or gas in contact with it. So the energy responsible for the phenomenon of surface tension, they may be thought of an approximately equivalent to the work or energy required to remove the surface layer of molecules in a unit area. So surface tension is typically measured in dynes per second. So the force in dynes is required to break a film for length 1 centimeter. Okay, so for different liquids, there is a different surface tension. For example, for hydrogen, it's 2.4 newtons per meter. For helium, it's 0.16 newtons per meter. Water is 0.072 newtons per meter. For ethanol, it's 22.0 newtons per meter. For NaCl, it's 114 newtons per meter. Now, that surface tension is the tendency of your liquids to liquid surfaces to shrink into minimum surface area possible, and surface tension is what allows heavier than water, that is denser than water, objects such as your razor blades, insects such as water striders, to float and slide on a water surface without becoming even partly submerged. So at liquid air interfaces, surface tension will result from greater attraction of liquid molecules to each other due to cohesion than to molecules in the air due to adhesion. And there are two primary mechanisms in play. So one is an inward force on surface molecules, which is causing the liquid to contract. And second is a tangential force parallel to the surface of the liquid. And this tangential force per unit length is generally referred to as the surface tension. Now, the net effect is the liquid behaves as its surface were covered with a stretched elastic membrane. And but this analogy, it must not be taken too far, as the tension in elastic membrane is dependent on the amount of deformation of the membrane, while surface tension is an inherent property of the liquid air or liquid vapor interface. So because the relatively high attraction of water molecules to each other through a web of hydrogen bonds, water with a higher tension and then most other fluids, so the surface tension is an important factor in the phenomenon of capillary. So surface tension, they have the higher dimension of force per unit length or of energy per unit area. So the two are equivalent, but when referring to energy per unit areas, it is common to use the term surface energy, so which is more general in sense that it applies also to solid. And in material science, the surface tension is used for their either surface stress or surface energy. So what are the causes of surface tension? Basically, due to cohesive forces, a molecule is pulled equally in every direction by neighboring liquid molecules, so resulting in a net force of zero. So the molecule at surfaces, they do not have same molecules on all sides of them, and therefore they are pulled inwards, and it creates some internal pressure, and it forces liquid surfaces to contract to minimum area, and this is also that attention parallel to the surface at liquid air interface, which will resist an external force due to cohesive nature of water molecules. Now, the force of attraction acting between the molecules of same type are called as your cohesive forces, while those acting between molecules of different types are called as your adhesive forces. Now, the balance between cohesion of liquid and its adhesion to the material of container, it determines degree of wetting and contact angle and the shape of your meniscus. So while cohesion, it dominates specifically, the adhesion energy is less than half of your cohesion energy, and the wetting is low, and the meniscus is convex and at vertical wall. So as for mercury in a glass container, so on the other hand, when adhesion, it dominates, so adhesion energy is more than that of half of cohesion energy, and the wetting is high, and the similar meniscus is concave. So as in water in a glass. Now, surface tension is responsible for the shape of liquid droplets. And although easily deformed, a droplet of water, it tends to be pulled into a spherical shape by the imbalance in cohesive forces of surface layer. And in absence of other forces, it drops off virtually all liquids without which would be approximately spherical. And the spherical shape, it minimizes the necessary wall tension of the surface layer, which will be according to Laplace's law. Now, another way to view the surface tension is in terms of energy. A molecule in contact with a neighbor is in lower state of energy than if it were alone. And now the interior molecule, it has many neighbors, as they can possibly have the boundary molecules as missing neighbors, which are as compared to your interior molecules, and therefore they have high energy. For liquid to minimize its energy state, the number of higher energy boundaries molecules must be minimized. Now, minimized number of boundary molecules result in your minimal surface area. So as a result of surface area minimization, the number surface will be assume that the smoothest shape, and it can, since any curvature in surface shape, it will result in greater area, and higher energy will also result. Now, what will be the effect of surface tension basically? Several effects of surface tension, it can be seen in various ways, like surface effect of ordinary water. Let's see. So the beading of rainwater on a waxing surface such as leaf, so water adheres weakly to wax and strongly to itself. So water clusters into droplets, and surface tension, it will give them their nearest spherical shape. So because a sphere has the smallest possible surface area to volume ratio, so the formation of drops, it occurs when a mass of liquid is stretched. And the water adhering to the faucet, gaining mass until it is stretched to a point where the surface tension can no longer keep the drop linked to the faucet. So it then separates the surface tension, separates and surface tension forms the drops into a sphere. So if a stream of water were running from the faucet, the stream would break up into drops during it falls. Now gravity, it stretches the stream, then surface tension pinches into spheres. floating of objects denser than water occurs when object is non-wettable and its weight is small enough to be borne by the forces arising from surface tension. For example, water striders, they use surface tensions to walk on the surface of a pond in the following way. Now, the non-wettability of water and strider's leg means that there is non-attraction between molecules on the leg and molecules of the water. So when leg pushes down on water, the surface tension of water also tries to reverse its flatness from its deformation due to the leg. Now, this behavior of water, it pushes water strider upward so it can stand on the surface of water as long as its mass is small enough that the water can support. Now, the surface of water, it behaves like an elastic film and to the insect bees and causes indentations in water's surface and increasing its surface area and the tendency of minimization of surface curvature, so area of water, and pushes the insect bees upward. Now, separation of water and oil, in the case of water or liquid wax, is caused by tension in the surface between your dissimilar liquids, and this type of surface tension is called interface tension, and but their chemistry is basically same. Now, tears of wine is the formation of the drops and rivulets on the side of glass containing an alcoholic beverage. So it causes a complex interaction between differing surface tensions of water and ethanol, and it is induced by the combination of surface tension modifications of water by ethanol together with ethanol evaporating faster than water. Now, surfactants which is the one of the most important term, which is also important physiologically for your body, that a surface tension is visible in some other phenomena, especially when surfactants are used to decrease it. So soap bubbles have a very large surface area with very little mass, and bubbles in pure water are unstable. So the addition of surfactants, however, they can be stabilizing effects on bubbles. And no, you should know that surfactants, they actually reduce surface tension of water by a factor of 3 or more. Now, emulsions of a colloid in which surface tension plays a role, and tiny fragments of oil is suspended in pure water while spontaneously assemble themselves into much larger masses. But the presence of surfactant, it provides a decrease in surface tension, and which affirm its stability of minute droplets of oil in the bulk of water, or vice versa. Now, this is all for today. I'll be discussing further about surface tension in your next sections. Until then, take care. Bye.